2015 has been a very interesting year for the European jet fuel market. Robust domestic production combined with very high flows into the region created length, and this length has been prevalent for most of the year. Very healthy contango encouraged storage, and this led to record high stocks across the European systems. This naturally created some logistical issues such as ullage constraints. Influx of product into the market resulted in record low prices. Premiums in jet fuel have plummeted to record low levels. Jet fuel flows from Russia feature quite regularly in the European market, but in 2015 those flows have become quite visible. Some of the Scandinavian countries combined with the UK have really increased their imports of Russian jet fuel. While Russia is not a prevalent source of supply of jet fuel into Europe, it is a rather interesting development. We're in Moscow today to discuss the European jet fuel market. To discuss the market and its trends with me, I'm joined by Kirill Molodenkov. Kirill is the Chief Commercial Officer for Rosneft Aero. Kirill, thank you very much for being here.
Hello, it's a pleasure.
Russian jet flows to Europe have increased for 2015. What has driven this increase? Has it been mostly the domestic drivers, such as the taxation policy, incremental capacity additions, and potentially weaker underlying demand in Russia?
Well, as you rightly said, the increase of export, increase of jet export was strongly affected by the production capacity. It literally increased in 2015, and low underlying demand of Russian airlines, especially it was in the first queue. And this underlying demand decrease was mostly affected by devaluation of ruble, which actually happened in 2015. According to data we have provided by the Cortes Information Center, in the first queue, from first Q to third Q in 2015, the production decreased. From the first Q actually decreased by 2%, which actually was close to 150,000 tons. I'm now saying about 9 months of 2015. And at the same time, the export rose by actually doubled from 800,000 tons to 1.5 million tons in 9 months. And actually it was seen in all information resources we have. And again, lower domestic demand can be accounted by the fact of the harsh economic situation in Russia, and we can see it by the demand of the passengers. Most of the people started to move from international destinations to local destinations, and the flight capacity actually grown up, but the number of flights has reduced, and it literally, if you see the numbers, we can say that 13 or 14% decrease was for international flights, and at the same moment 16% growth of domestic flights. And as you can see from the newspapers, last year, especially the end of the year, many airlines shifted their planes from Russia to other destinations, and it just went down by 20%. They just started to go from Russia.
Do you expect these flows to Europe to remain fairly regular? Do you envisage a further increase in Russia's exports of jet fuel in the coming years as the domestic capacity increases?
Yes, we believe that the demand will stay modest as it is. It will not grow significantly as it used to be in the last couple of years. And at the same moment, as we know that refineries have plans to expand their production capacity and increase the light yields, meaning that the production of diesel and jet fuel will increase. So those two factors should lead to expand of the export capacity of jet fuels from Russia, and we think it could go mostly to European market and to Southeast Asia in some coming years. Saying that, we see that Rosneft also has plans to expand its jet production capacity. Saying this, we believe and we have a plan that Tuapse refinery will start to produce jet, and it will produce jet A1 quality, which is absolutely fine for European market, and the production capacity could be close to 8 100,000 tons per year, which is huge. And from the plants we have now, most of this product should go to Europe by sea.
Kirill, so you talked a little bit about specification, but are there any specification issues that impact the Russian jet flows to Europe?
Today, Russian refineries mostly produce TS1 and RT. Well, there is some refineries which can produce JT1, but the most of demand is TS1 and RT. All airlines which use Airbus and Boeing planes are okay with the quality. And we've been to different forums, and we had a number of conversations with the experts from Europe, States, and other parts of the world, and everyone agreed that, actually acknowledged that TS1 and RT are absolutely fine quality grades. But meanwhile, we have an issue that TS and RT, when it's been exported to Europe, is being exported as a fraction for further use and maybe a mix of the other, some other products. And this thing is we're working on, because having it as a fraction, it just decreases the price of exports. So in coming years, we believe that we can harmonize both Russian and world systems. I mean, system to say that the quality of fuel is absolutely fine. Not only experts to say, but also to put on paper.
Kirill, thank you very much for taking your time to answer our question. Really appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for your time.
Some of the trends that we have observed for 2015 seem to be still featuring in 2016, while the length in jet fuel seems to be more contained as the flow from other regions have to a degree subsided. It is still very much a buyer's market.